Hello, my beautiful and courageous friends. It's Natalie Kelly here. And today I'm here with Dr. Lori Chaikin, who's a rehab optometrist here in Alameda, California.
When the waves came and when the storm raged, found myself falling into the ground. When the wind blew, that's when it fell through, and I don't know how to turn it around. I know there's more to me than the wreckage you see. There's more to be. I'm still on the journey.
When you walk into a complex visual environment, there actually is a visual overwhelm syndrome that we have identified. And in that situation, it's a combination of lights, and it's a combination of a lot of sensory information that you can no longer organize. And you may walk into a Target or whatever, big box, sort of a shopping experience. And now there are so many different pieces of information that are all calling for your attention. Yeah. And they're very specifically designed to call your attention. So if you can no longer filter what's important and what's not important, then everything is calling your attention. What calls your attention then calls your eyes to move over and say, well, what's that? What's that? What's that? And so you're looking left, right, up, down, near, far, and it's no longer in an organized manner. That all comes back to central visual information processing with peripheral visual information. And it's a very common breakdown that occurs where the information that's coming from central vision and peripheral vision is no longer organized in a normal manner. And so you're being pulled in a million different directions, and you don't know how to organize it. And
wait, so, that's so right on.
People who experience that, they can only tolerate a certain amount of that. And then all of a sudden they go, I have to get out of here.
Now.
Right now.
Yeah.
Or I'm going to fall apart.
Yeah. Panic.
And you panic, anxiety,
yep.
Shut down, and you have to go into a calm situation so you can regroup and you can get yourself back together.
Yeah. I can't tell you how many times I've loaded up my grocery cart and then had to run out of the store and just abandon the whole thing.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's like, I got to get out of here. No shopping done.
Oh.
Go home.
Wow.
Yeah.
And part of that is also the lighting. So the fluorescent lighting that occurs in most of those shopping situations has a huge effect on brain injury. And one of the reasons why is that fluorescent lighting has a lower flicker frequency. Mm-hmm. So flicker frequency threshold.
Easy for you to say.
People with brain injury have a much lower threshold to that. And so the light is actually flickering and you become more sensitive to it.
That's true.
So it's not only that, but it's also that the rate of flicker is something that people become sensitive to. Now, most people with normal brain integration can tune that out, but people with brain injury may not be able to tune that out. And so the flicker rate itself becomes something that is entraining the brain pattern. So your own brain pattern becomes influenced by that rate of flicker that now is causing you to become disorganized and you can't control it.
Fascinating.
So that's why we use...
So the flicker's going at a certain speed.
Right.
I think it's 1,000 flickers per second.
Mm-hmm.
And the brain starts to entrain with that and create the same brainwave pattern.
Because it can't not.
Which is why I used to walk in a room and have to leave immediately if there was a fluorescent light on.
Correct.
Wow.
I have a patient who is a doctor, MD, public service sector doctor, that had a head injury. And as a result of that, one of her remaining triggers is fluorescent lights that is so severe that when she walks into a particular fluorescent lighting, first her speech goes, mm-hmm. she can no longer talk, mm-hmm. and then her lower extremities go and she's on the floor.
Wow.
She can no longer walk. And so she now knows what those triggers are.
I can relate to that.
And she can, wow, she knows what to do. I mean, she has...
Turn the light off.
Turn the light off. She has visors
yeah.
and hats that she uses, and she's tried some different colored filters that didn't particularly help her, but we've had other people that were able to respond well to different colored filters.
Yeah.
That's the way to deal
so
with
that. In that person's example, that's a perfect example of how the visual overwhelm can trigger the brain to shut down and then nothing else is working.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah.
And then if you add to that someone that also has auditory overwhelm, combined with the visual overwhelm. It's just a recipe for disaster.
Right. It makes grocery shopping very difficult.
It does.
I don't know how to turn it around. I know there's more to me than the wreckage you see. There's more to me. I'm still on the journey.